So welcome everyone. This is Social Dissonance. It's a durational concert. I have to inform you about some things. First of all, this door will be closed from now on, and we can use only that door as an exit. It's already closed. Sorry. Yes, but this is very close to the central entrance of the building, so it's not so difficult. Also, I have to ask you for stay for the whole hour of the concert because it's very important for us in order to build a situation in this space. But if you want to live in the middle of the concert, you can, of course, but you will be asked to give us some feedback. And the second thing is that we are being filmed. And this film is right now live streamed on Periscope, and it's going to be archived and projected tomorrow on this screen. So yes, if you cannot commit that you will stay for the whole hour, or if you don't want to be filmed, or if you don't feel like participating, maybe you can leave now. Thank you. That door, please. And now, please stop. We would like to ask you to look at this room. And now, to tell us and to tell to everybody how it makes you feel.
Just say it like this.
Mm-hmm.
It's good. Feels very high. Interesting. Nice feeling.
Stay here, I have money in my right hand. It's okay? You like that?
It feels open.
Feels, sorry?
Open. Nervous. Very brightful. And clear, white, and empty. It's pure and holy, pure light. Curious.
Curious.
Like a well.
Proper. Proper.
Empty space can be filled.
And how does the space make you behave?
Upward.
How does the space make you behave?
I think the space itself does not make me behave. It's
social situation. Combination of space and people. Please exit. Okay.
How does the space change the way that you move, the way that you act, the way that you express yourself?
People, yeah.
But it's also maybe a little bit with this very high, this feeling of being a bit trapped, I think, a little bit trapped with the others, because it's so high up the light. Maybe if it were windows here, maybe it would be easier to contact the outside.
Yeah.
So we are very.
Connection, but also disconnection. Because, like you said, some of you in the same room, you don't hear each other.
And also the echoes. Or bad,
so the space brings you closer because of the echo. It makes you talk quieter. So you will be better understandable.
So it would be better without the echo?
Sorry. Excuse me. Okay. He had a breathing problem.
The question was if the space would be better without the echo. And I think I can only tell you once we get out of here, for now, if it brings some uncomfortableness, but also at the same time, adds a special element to the experience. So,
Would you like to share your thoughts with everyone?
I think this we're just like being caged in this small space, but we feel isolated although there are so many people in the same space. So why not let's break the ice? Like, even though we're watching them putting on the curtains, you know, it's so boring. Why don't we just do something more interesting?
Yeah, we just discuss with each other because we are friends, but yeah, we don't know which country you come from, so maybe we can introduce with each other.
Yeah. Yeah, we got time. Yeah. It's so boring to watch them doing this kind of stuff.
Right. It's also boring to see where you come from.
Yeah, it is. That's the point. Maybe because we are not with each other.
Well, we are exchanging communication. Kind of just like experiencing more
instead of just 40 minutes just west, yeah. Or just talk something maybe more interesting.
So your idea is to sing something
together. Yeah.
Over here. Who was next?
I was. So, my name is Smaragda.
Interesting.
My name is Du Jing.
Du Jing. bringing other problems. Mächt Hild.
And let's move it just a bit closer to the fabric.
My name is Sabina.
Hello. Watching us, and he shared his name. His name is Minus Plato. Synchronize like one tone or one note. Just a bit closer to the fabric.
Thank you.
Is any one of you singing in a, I don't know,
choir?
Choir? Yes? Yeah. Mm-hmm. What are you singing at the moment?
Mendelssohn Lobgesang.
Could you sing it for us? No?
Does everybody know
where
we shall overcome?
Yes.
Yeah. I think that should everybody know.
That's true.
And it's a good point for this. Too.
What's the song?
We shall overcome.
No, I mean, why would we all know it? Like, is it like a world known, like
yeah,
universal?
Well known.
So if you don't know it, it means that you don't know, like, and if you don't come from the same, you know, like, then you don't know it.
Okay.
It's a generation.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm sure. Like, we don't know it for sure. I don't think this world will know it. But we can try. I've heard about it, yeah. But let's try.
It's very easy to learn.
We simply start. So you don't bother if we simply start and see what happens?
No, of course.
Do you know the song?
We do.
No?
We shall overcome.
Oh,
You didn't intend this.
I am wondering if this is making us more connected and if what we're doing here is going to last when we leave the space.
So it's going to?
Yes, if this what we're bringing here, if we are building something, if we are going to continue outside, or if it is just for now. And we're just having fun, singing familiar songs that are not familiar for everyone, actually.
Any better idea?
I'm just asking. It's not to say that what we're doing is not important, but I'm wondering if it's going to last after we leave the space.
Solution. To sing is a very good solution, I think.
It's a peaceful solution.
Yeah, peaceful.
I think it is interesting that we all come in here as individuals in a group, and then when you share things together, you become a character that you get to a certain level, you get to know people come out of their anonymousness. Interesting to take outside. Mm. Yes.
Do you remember one name of someone else
Christina,
in this room?
I don't know the basic name. Christina was your.
No, it's not her.
Doesn't matter.
Yeah.
Jürgen?
Jürgen.
It's just the one beside me.
My
Barbara? Is that you? Barbara? No.
They share their names, even if they don't recommend every name, at least they share the names. Also could be a small flag.
Interesting thing, it took you to start. I mean, if you hadn't started, I'd say, but I mean,
we spend an hour here, but it takes us for like 30 minutes to get started and to talk. So we spend the 30 minutes just getting familiar with the atmosphere, not willing to know anybody. Maybe some of us have the willingness to communicate with each other, but because we are from different countries, we speak different language, so we just feel that we are so isolated and we're not that willing to talk.
I think this is because it's not a usual school.
Yeah. It's kind of tricky.
But the gift, the present you made was being honest. You gave an honest answer to a serious question that made the space open for the next one to get another idea.
Someone says something that's honest and maybe happens something. Yeah.
And I'm just, there has to be someone just speaking now or doing something stupid or to get start with the group to combine each other together. Yeah.
Another question, if you are in our country,
I would never do that.
Yeah, maybe.
Where are you from?
Yeah.
Where are you from? China.
Because in Asia, people maybe don't do this.
A different chance to experience something different, that I will stand out and speak. That's so new to me. Yeah, not the usual.
Yeah.
Very new.
But be sure that it's not typical for us as well.
I would like to know what's your motivation to come from China to Kassel to work for Henka.
Oh! It's a very long story.
Yeah, it's a long story because 10 years ago I came here. And then I think, well, it's a great idea of this exhibition, so I came here. Five years later, and then 5 years later, this became
a tradition.
Yeah.
When did you come for the first time?
2007.
And why?
I am the participant of Eyewitness. Yeah, one of Eyewitness.
One of these thousand people invited.
Yeah, I'm one of them.
Okay.
Yeah, and then
okay.
And come here, and then I think it's very interesting.
You
work? No, I was in school and he invited one of some of my.
They just shipped like 1,001 Chinese
veritas
from China to Kassel and put them here and to record them how would we react in this world. Because most of them cannot speak German or speak English.
In 2007, I can't say this word to you, and I can't understand what you say, but now I can. It's a very interesting experience.
Okay, do you think that the art that's presented here in Kassel is a kind of European imperialism to force, for example, China to make the same kind of art? Like you can see here, or do you think that China, maybe for China it's complete difficult to understand what this European kind of art you can see here?
It's a very big question for me because I'm just a design student, I'm not art students. Maybe sometimes it's for me, I can understand some of them, but some of them I can't. Yeah, I
but it's everyone's case, even
the
European ones.
Yeah, so for me, I can understand some of them, and when I read some catalogs, I can know more. Yeah, but I don't know I understand right or wrong. I just follow the guide sometimes. Yeah.
But this year is much more closely related to politics.
Yeah.
If you know more about politics, it's easier for you to know the story behind those arts. And also, for me, art is something like hard to understand. Like I once know that scientists did an experiment. They put the picture of like kids, like 3 years old, with those paintings painted by the artist, and to ask people to recognize which one is belong to the artist themselves. But for most people, it's hard for us to understand the modern art. We cannot recognize which one belongs to the child and which one was from the artist. So I guess we were just struggling to understand those stuff behind the story.
There's a joke in Germany, probably in other countries as well, where the cleaner in the room and the
becomes, is it art or can I throw it away? I mean,
today's performance was a bit weird for me because it was my first day in Kassel, and I had heard the crazy stories about the German audience and how hard they are compared to the Athenians that I knew. Don't press this button, please. She will do it. Thank you.
But I don't see it.
I don't know. You can see it.
I love the space, even though it reminds me of a psychiatric ward, but I think it fits our performance. In the beginning, I didn't like the singing part. I do like silences in general, so when we were trying to break it, I think that it was losing power. But in the end, somehow it worked, which is good. But I do believe we could have done better in creating the emotions that we wanted people to feel from the space, and then understand the difference when the curtains came up. How difficult was the communication due to the acoustics, and then this problem solving changed the architecture at the same time solving a problem that can help the performance.
I actually did not think when they started with this that it would be any productive. I just thought it's another provocation by you. You just now do this and we still walk around yet.
I wonder if we would have started singing if the acoustics of the room were not such, or if we were not inside an art space. Like if you were inside the space and we were not already making sound, I wonder how this would have developed, or if you haven't said this before, so that we could find something to entertain ourselves. I wonder if this would be the same.
I guess this was more important than the very intensive acoustic of this room, because this presence of such an acoustic is not needed to start singing. It is, would be impossible now, even though it is more reduced.
Well, I think this acoustics initially was the acoustics of the cathedral, and very anti to fill the cathedral. Not have sang as well if this had been a small room with lots of things on the wall that endures the echo.
So it's a good feeling to feel
like the cathedral sound? Yes, it is. I think so.
I just think
we might sing this room.
We just came from the orangery and where they sing it, and so it's like
you were just saying.
Yeah,
it's filmed there.
Yeah,
I've seen it.
Should they stay or should they go?
experience the change with and without, because with echo goes away. So it's good to have the echo initially and not the echo disappears.
Okay, so you think we should put on the curtains every day?
Yeah.
Well, maybe you can just put it to the side and then open them up to show the difference.
Are you not putting them up? No. Yes, it's the first time you get them up.
Okay.
No need to do it every morning. We never did it before. So this is an experiment.